Hello and welcome. My name is Christoph Ruehle. I'm a product expert for SAP S4HANA, and today I would like to talk to you about building a chatbot that communicates with SAP S4HANA. So let's take a look at the slides. So first, about the agenda, we would like to start with SAP Conversational AI Services, the platform itself, then talk about how to build a chatbot for SAP S4HANA, talk specifically about the demo and take a look at a working model, take a look at the architecture, and then take a look at the SAP Conversational AI plan with SAP S4HANA going forward and with the horizontal user experience approach of chatbots in SAP S4HANA. So with that, I would like to start about talking about the SAP Conversational AI platform. So as you might be aware of SAP Copilot, we had the end-to-end bot building platform used by SAP and external users to train, build, integrate, and connect and monitor chatbots. And we'll have the same with SAP Conversational AI. So in 2016, we released SAP Copilot. In 2018, we had an acquisition of a small French startup based in Paris, in France, called Recast AI. And then in 2019, we renamed Recast AI and the whole platform to SAP Conversational AI. In 2020, so of this year, we are integrating and focusing on the integration of the SAP Conversational AI platform into SAP S4HANA and focusing on the first chatbots communicating directly with SAP S4HANA. So all of this is leading basically to our general availability starting next year. And this is what we are working for and planning towards. So SAP Conversational AI is ready to use as of now. So you can go to the links shown here on the slides. You can start with fun and easy tutorials, how to build joke chatbots, et cetera, to get a glimpse of how SAP Conversational AI works. And then you can start building your own chatbots, not just for SAP S4HANA system specifically, but for any system. So you can use these chatbots later to integrate into your landscape and then use it productively. And first, then it will be a charge and the pricing model comes into place. Until then, it's free of charge, it's easy to use, and feel free to go there, as said, and register for free. So with that, talking about specifically about a bot building example for SAP S4HANA and Labs preview. So we want to focus specifically on how to build a chatbot with SAP Conversational AI that communicates with SAP S4HANA. So in this specific example, the chatbot supports a user with a business role in SAP S4HANA of operational purchaser in their daily tasks. So to use the Conversational AI platform, you really have to think about how you want to use it. So you can easily use conversational AI to trigger any intelligent processes connected to a robotic process automation bot, and or even use it as a support system for your end users. However, in our specific case for SAP S4HANA, we want to use it to improve the user experience by delivering chatbots with a human-like communication. So we want to use it to enhance the user productivity, avoid lengthy navigation by enabling quick data access and retrieving relevant business information, and also provide guidance for new or occasional users by guiding them to the appropriate information resources. So here we want to kick off the development process by choosing the OData services we require to cover the business role of operational purchaser in our case. So therefore, the available OData services and APIs are all documented in the SAP S4HANA documentation. So we want to, of course, choose the specific OData services and choose the ones of a monitor purchase order item, manage purchase order item, monitor purchase requisition items, and manage purchase requisition. So then as a next step, we would want to generate sentences for business objects. So this is the intent content. And of course, we want to have as a navigational, as a horizontal approach, we want to cover all of these OData services, which I've just mentioned, of monitoring and to manage. So for monitoring, it's basically a show me skill specifically of a chatbot. So show me any business object, in our case, the purchase order or the purchase requisition. And for manage purchase order or manage purchase requisition, this would be a so-called CRUD approach, which is create, read, update, and delete. We'll talk about this later. So for this example, we generate sentences. For example, show me a purchase order item XYZ. Update purchase requisition XYZ, etc. So we create a bunch of sentences. As the next step, we tag these entities and create entities therefore. So in this specific example, as you can see on the right-hand picture, we have basically three entities which we tag directly in the specific sentences, in this specific utterances. And then therefore create entities such as attributes and also the specific values of these attributes. So as a next step, we connect this bot to the backend by creating and configuring a destination in SAP Cloud Platform to connect it directly to your SAP S/4HANA backend. And as a next step, five, we describe the action and the chatbots and what they should do based on skills. So this is basically manual development effort. As of now, of course, we try to make this as easy for our customers as possible. And we want to develop these skills, define the triggers, basically send these requests to the backend and define the displayed response for this. As a next step, then we connect this specific bot then to a web client in Fury Launchpad. And with web client, I mean the chat UI and the channel where the chatbots should be used by our end users directly in your SAP S/4HANA Fury Launchpad. And once that is done and the SAP Conversational AI chatbots are being used, you could monitor your bot on SAP Conversational AI. There's a log monitoring. We can see what works and what not, and can continuously enhance these chatbots. So as a next step, taking a look at our architecture, and here we can see the whole picture of the process, what is happening basically behind the curtain. So here a customer who is an SAP S/4HANA end users is using the SAP S/4HANA landscape on a mobile or on a desktop device. So here they're using the web client, which I've mentioned beforehand, which is directly embedded in the Fury Launchpad in your SAP S/4HANA systems. Here the user types in a question, which is an utterance, and this utterance is then being sent to SAP Conversational AI directly to the NLP engine, the natural language processing engine, and an intent classification is happening. There is also entity detection happening. And while we are sending this utterance, we are using SSO propagation, which is a single sign-on authentication of the end user. So based on this intent classification and entity detection, the specific skill which we have defined beforehand is being triggered. So this skill, like for example, show me purchase orders, is then being sent to the SAP S/4HANA backend. And this request is based on this OData service, which is being triggered, sends a data response back to the skill, back to the natural language processing platform, to SAP Conversational AI, and sends then the displayed response back to the web client, which is shown to the user and take action, follow-up actions on it. So now we would like to take a look at a demo together. Okay, so here we want to take a look at the demo of how the SAP Conversational AI platform works. So we can see here an end user is using the SAP Conversational AI icon on the top right and types in their specific question, which they have based on the operational purchase of chatbots. So in that case, the end user is asking the question, show me purchase orders for plan 1010. The bot presents a list with results, and the user chooses one and then can jump directly to the specific Fury application. Okay. And here we can see a lab's preview of SAP Conversational AI and SAP S4HANA. So this means basically this is in our current plans of SAP S4HANA. And we have basically the following building blocks of SAP Conversational AI going forward. So we want to have the digital assistant as our central point embedded directly in the Fury launchpad. For SAP S4HANA, which is based on the web client of SAP Conversational AI. So the digital assistant is a chat UI directly embedded in the SAP Fury user experience. It has in-context chat. Previously, as you might be aware of, SAP Copilot, and enables users to share their content with users from other business areas, basically within their company. And with business application context. So you can create notes and capture screenshots, navigate to these apps individually, and also annotate these screenshots. You can recognize business objects within the application context of the digital assistant, and a direct integration with the digital support experience for quick creation of support tickets, feature requests, etc. is possible. The next building block we have is the SAP Conversational AI platform itself, which I've described previously and which we are using to build these individual chatbots. So the SAP Conversational AI platform is an end-to-end bot building platform used by SAP as set to train, build, integrate, connect, and monitor chatbots. So here we have a broad coverage of language support, and the SAP Conversational AI platform is based on text-based natural language processing only. So there is no voice recognition yet. Maybe this is in the plans for the future, but this is the current status. Of course, customers and partners should be able to customize chatbots released for SAP S4HANA specifically on SAP Conversational AI. Furthermore, as a third block, we have the SAP S4HANA pre-delivered chatbots based on SAP Conversational AI. And this is this will be chatbots similar to the one we have seen previously in the demo. And it's a pre-delivered chatbots which are based on a business role in SAP S4HANA with a horizontal user experience. So the first two chatbots are covering the areas of procurement, operational purchaser, and finance cost center owner. And there is also an extensibility model to integrate and consume custom chatbots. Together with the pre-delivered SAP S4HANA chatbots. So what does it mean to have a horizontal user experience? Here's a little bit of an overview of our plan. So with SAP Conversational AI, a business role in SAP S4HANA is covered horizontally. That means a user is not using individual skills, but one role-based bot which covers a significant number of use cases and intents. So the focus here is on value and volume, compared to previously with SAP Copilot. So we differ here between business use cases based on the CRUD approach, which I've explained earlier, the create, read, update, and delete. We have a navigation use case and an FAQ use case, which is the frequently asked question use case. So I'm very happy also to announce that if you are very interested in SAP Conversational AI, you would be able to reach out to us directly to get started in the beta program and to test the first chatbots available with SAP Conversational AI and SAP S4HANA. So the two chatbots, which I've mentioned previously, are in the field of operational purchaser and cost center owner, so finance and procurement. So if you are interested, if you are an SAP S4HANA user with a version of 19.09, and you are very interested in testing or even using these chatbots productively, feel free to reach out to my colleague, Daniel. You can see the email here on the screen, and then we'll get you hooked up and looking forward basically to hear your feedback on this. So with that, that covers my session for SAP Conversational AI and SAP S/4HANA. I would like to mention here the related SAP TechEd sessions and of course the public SAP websites. So feel free to take a look at these individual sessions and also continue your learning experience at SAP TechEd in 2020. And with that, I'm thanking you very much for attending this session. Thank you. Thank you.